No, he came through that door there.
And so he actually pointed the gun at you?
Yes, he jumped up and was pointing. I was screaming, and I just kept running.
Senior citizen last week found a man with a gun in her bedroom. She screamed. He ran. Quiet, Gates Mills. Days later, a gunman robbed former Brown star Joe Juravicius, also in Gates Mills.
We were just robbed at our house. Someone came to our back door and robbed us.
Now investigators are looking into connections between those two crimes and a man just released from prison.
It was my husband. He was at the back door. He opened the door and he said, get all the money that you can.
You're lucky he took off.
I'm very lucky a lot to find someone hiding in your bedroom with a gun.
Well, I've never seen her that shook up in my life. You know, we've been married for 40 years, so.
But that couple and the former pro football player might get justice. Hours after the holdup of Juravicius, multiple police agencies hauled in a suspect.
So what do we know about this guy jumping out of the shadows, getting into homes, terrorizing people here in a place where you rarely hear about anything like this? Well, the I-team has found the suspect, a young guy, already with a growing criminal record.
That suspect just released from prison in May for robbery, stolen property, and burglary. He had a long record as a juvenile. Multiple sources say a key clue in tracking him down now, he wore an ankle bracelet so authorities could monitor him on parole.
If somebody has committed a crime, obviously he did. He ought to be, you know, somehow locked up or somehow confined to his own home.
Juravicius told the I-team, quote, I support the police department. I support the FBI. I support the American flag. Meantime, here, no matter what happens in court, they may never get over what happened in the house.
I was screaming and needing help, saying there's a gun, man with a gun in the house.